Dr. Joe DiMarco, chiropractor and owner of Okra Med Health. We're talking today about how to strengthen the glute medius muscle. Now, the glute medius is a real important muscle of the body. Whether we're in the gym weightlifting, performing squats or deadlifting, or just performing our normal activities of daily living, this is an important muscle, and unfortunately, it's a muscle that's commonly overstretched and weak. Now, the glute medius originates off of the outer surface of the ilium, and then its fibers all converge down into a single tendon that attaches onto the greater trochanter of the femur. When the fibers are contracted, one of the functions of the glute medius is it will abduct the hip. It brings the leg away from the body. It's also a very important muscle when we're walking because it's a pelvic stabilizer. So when I place my right leg down onto the ground and I'm lifting my left leg up to step forward, my glute medius on the right is contracted and it's stabilizing my pelvis and it's keeping it level until my left leg comes down onto the ground. As my weight transfers onto my left leg, my left glute medius contracts as my right leg comes up, keeping my pelvis stable. So it's a pelvic stabilizer, and that brings me to my next point. The glute medius is very important for balance. Now, if you're over the age of 50 and you're watching this video, balance is very important because a major way that people over the age of 50 get injured is they lose their balance, they fall, and they get injured. The glute medius is so important in balance. You know, research shows that if you can't stand on one leg for at least 30 seconds, your incidence or your chance of falling goes up dramatically. And when you're standing on one leg, which muscle do you think is doing a lot of the work stabilizing the pelvis and helping to maintain balance? It's your glute medius. So that's another reason why it's so critical and so important to keep that glute medius strong. The glute medius finally is involved with some rotation of the hip also. So why is the glute medius commonly overstretched and weak? Well, overstretched has to do a lot with our daily habits, our daily activities. For example, if you're someone who does a lot of sitting and you're in the habit of crossing your legs, this is really a bad position for your glute medius. In a seated position with the legs crossed, you have the glute medius in an overstretched position. So if you're sitting like this hour after hour during the course of the day, you're constantly keeping this overstretched position on the glute medius, which is bad for that muscle. If you're a side sleeper and you're sleeping on your side at night and you're not using a pillow between your knees to keep the legs and pelvis stabilized, the glute medius is going to be overstretched in this position. Of course, if you're in bed 6, 7, 8 hours a night, you're leaving that glute medius in an overstretched position for an extended period of time. Other bad habits that people have, oftentimes you'll see you'll see people that when they're standing for a while, they tend to just kind of put all their weight on the one leg, whether it's the left or the right, and they stand with their weight in this position all off to the side. In this position, I'm overstretching and straining my glute medius, so that's another bad habit to be in. And finally, people that sit a lot also sometimes sit with their knees in really close and bowed in. And in that position, once again, the glute medius is in an overstretched position if you stay like that hour after hour. So all those little habits that a lot of people do lead up day after day, week after week, month after month, and you end up with overstretched glute medius muscles. Why is it weak? Well, if you're relatively sedentary, you're not out doing any walking, you're not exercising regularly, the glute medius for the most part isn't being activated day to day because it's the type of muscle, as we mentioned, that abducts the hip. And unless you're intentionally doing this type of a motion, you're usually not using the glute medius during the course of the day. So it's overstretched and it becomes weak. So what we're gonna do today is I'm gonna go over some great exercises on how to strengthen this glute medius muscle. Okay, so for these first couple of exercises, you just need something to step up on, something small. I'm using a yoga block. If you have a small step stool, that's fine. I'm gonna step up with my right leg, and because of that, we're gonna be working at first the right glute medius. The important part of this exercise is I wanna be on my right leg, but I want my right knee to be straight. So we don't want any bend in the right knee. And I'm up on the yoga block, so my left leg is kinda dangling. And from this position, I'm just going to let the left leg and hip drop down. I usually go down till I feel like the foot touch the floor, and I'm kind of stretching that glute medius in this position, and then I'm going to contract and bring the pelvis to a straight position. So I'm going to drop down and bring it up. And when I come up, I usually give it a 2002 count, 1001, 1002, then drop back down, come back up, 1001, 1002. Now, if there's a balance issue at first, just hold on to a chair in front of you, hold on to the wall, but eventually we wanna work up, so we're doing three sets of 15 repetitions. Now, this looks like an easy exercise. However, you'll be surprised how quickly you're gonna get a burn in that glute medius on the side that you're working, especially if it's weak and it hasn't been exercised. This is a great way of activating those fibers. If you're not sure if you're activating the glute medius, just get your fingers in on that outside surface of the ilium, kind of dig your fingers in there. And as you do the repetitions, you drop down, as you contract up, just see if you can feel those fibers tightening up and contracting of the glute medius on the right side. Okay, once you get up to three sets of 15 repetitions, you'll be ready to add on to this second part of the exercise. So we're gonna add on, not only gonna work the right glute medius, we're gonna work and activate the left glute medius on the same exercise. So I'm gonna start just the same exact way. Right knee is straight. I drop the left leg and the left hip towards the ground till my foot touches. I come up, 1001, 1002. From this position, now I'm gonna abduct the left side. Come back down, that's a one count. Drop down, activate, 1001, 1002. Abduct the left side, bring it back. That's a two count now. So we're gonna do three sets and we're gonna build up to 15 repetitions on that. So of course with that exercise, now we're working the right glute medius, and now we've added in, we're working the left glute medius at the same time. Once again, try to work up to three sets of 15 repetitions. That's a great way of engaging both glute mediuses, and at the same time, you're working on your balance. Like I said, start with a chair or hold on to the wall, but eventually I'd like to see all of you be able to get up to the point where you can perform these three sets, coming up, coming out to the side, and back down without any assistance whatsoever. Okay, next exercise. And once again, it's okay to start with something low like this. Eventually work. This is an exercise where you would want to build up the height. It's just going to be a small one-legged squat. So I'm up on the right leg. I'm going to just bend my knee now and squat down until my foot touches the floor. And then I'm going to come back up and I'm going to try to stand up nice and straight and engage that right glute medius. Once again, I'm going to drop down till my leg touches the floor. And then I'm going to step up. And as I squeeze out the knee, I'm squeezing that glute medius and trying to keep my balance once again. So that's the motion if you need to put your arms out in front. Eventually, of course, it'd be good to just try to, once you can get to three sets of 15 repetitions on this one-legged squat, and I'm going off a very low, obviously, yoga block, but you know, we're trying to engage that muscle, and if it's weak, I want you to start with something low like this and eventually build it up and build it up until you can actually work it where you don't even need the block and you can just actually just perform a one-legged squat. Once again, three sets of 15. Every time you get to three sets of 15 and it seems too easy, then that's when you're gonna raise up the height and go start again trying to work up the three sets of 15 repetitions. Okay, another great exercise for the glute medius is side planks. So if I'm on the floor on my side, I'm lying on my right side, so I'm gonna be working my right glute medius. I'm on my right elbow. I have my legs out straight like this, one left on top of the right. And from this position, I'll just get my arm out of the way so you can see the movement. I'm just gonna contract my right glute medius, and I'm gonna lift up, 1001, 1002, let the hip come back down, touch down, 1001, 1002. Try not to come down and just totally relax and rest. I try to come up, 1001, 1002, come back lower slowly, let the hip touch, and then go again, 1001, 1002. Working this motion back three sets, once again, of 15 repetitions. When you feel that this exercise has become a little bit too easy, then you can add on a second part, just like on the other exercise we just went over. You can actually work this so that we're gonna activate the right glute medius and the left glute medius. So the way it's gonna be performed is we're gonna repeat that beginning section of the exercise. So I'm gonna come up, 1001, 1002, at which point, raise the left leg, come back down, touch the hip. That's a one count. Come back up, raise the leg, come back down, lower the hip again. So the both motions is just counting as one repetition. So I lift up, I raise the leg, come down, and touch the hip down. Three sets of 15 repetitions on that exercise. Once the initial movement becomes too easy, add on that second part. We now, once again, you're going to activate the right glute medius and the left glute medius. That's a great exercise. It's quite challenging. Take your time, build up. When you can build up to three sets of 15, you're going to notice a big change in the strength of that glute medius. Okay, so this final exercise, I really enjoy this one. You can either use a cable machine. I'm using exercise bands. I have an exercise band with an ankle attachment on my right ankle, and then the other end of the band, I have a door attachment on the bands that's underneath the door to stabilize it. So I'm using just a band set for this exercise. What I like about this exercise is we're going to work both the left and right glute medius muscles at the same exact time. In fact, the band is on my right leg, and you would think that the right leg is actually going to get the brunt of this workout, but it's not. The left side, the left glute medius, is actually going to get more of the burn on this exercise than the right, and I'll explain why in a second. So from this position, I'm going to step out far enough from the band so I have some tension where it's going to pull my right leg kind of across my left leg. So that's kind of the starting point. And then I'm going to abduct the right hip, the right leg, out to the side like that, contracting the right glute medius, then I'm gonna come across again to that position. So that would be a one count. So I'm gonna bring it out as far as you can till you feel that the tension on that, and depending on how tight you have your band, and come across. Now, like I said, you would imagine that this right glute medius is doing most of the work here, but actually it's not. The left is never getting a resting part to this entire exercise. The left glute medius, once you start this exercise, is in constant contraction, stabilizing my pelvis, whereas the right, actually as I come across, is kind of resting a little bit until I contract it again when I abduct the leg. So the right is actually, you know, getting a good workout and a good pump from doing this exercise. However, once this exercise starts and the right leg is up off the ground, through the entire set, my left glute medius is constantly contracted. So when you get done, you know, your right glute medius is going to feel a pump from the exercise, but your left glute medius is going to be exhausted. So that's what I really like about that. You're working the right glute medius. The left is doing all the stabilizing. It's getting a workout. You're working on your balance. Initially start by holding on to something if you need to, but try to build up to three sets, 15 repetitions without holding on to anything. When that becomes too easy, just increase the resistance on your bands, or if you're using some weight, add a little extra weight. But that's the exercise. From this position, starting position, we're just abducting the leg, coming across, abducting the leg, just like that, three sets, 15 repetitions. All right, so start working those exercises. You don't have to do them every day, but be consistent, work them every other day. You're gonna notice a big improvement in your balance, in your daily activity, but especially in the gym, you're gonna notice your squat's gonna improve, your deadlift's gonna improve, all those type of lifts are gonna improve by strengthening those glute medius muscles. I want to thank everyone for giving my channel so much support, going to my website, www.okramedhealth.com. We have fascia release instruments and tools. We have exercise equipment. We offer fitness programs. I appreciate the amount of people that go over to the site and purchase. It helps keep this channel going. I'm also very excited. We're building a new website, and on my new website, we're actually going to have a membership area where people can join, and I'm going to offer exclusive videos. We're going to have a forum so people can shoot me questions and I'll get right back to them. It'll be a private forum. We're going to have information on staying healthy, what to eat, how to exercise, and how to keep healthy, because that's what Okramed Health is all about. Hey, listen, if you're enjoying these videos, please subscribe to my channel, Okramed Health, on YouTube. Questions about exercises or injuries, just leave a comment in the comment section below. I do everything I can to get back to everybody. And don't forget, Okramed Health is here to keep you fit forever.